What's going on, guys? My name is Pedrotsky, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up a Factorio dedicated server using Pterodactyl. Now, if you don't know what Pterodactyl is, it's a game server management panel, and basically it allows you to manage game servers, install them, set up bots. Just like, check this out. Look, we've got a Sven co-op server here, and it's just so much easier to do everything through this panel than like having to log into a server or into some command line or do whatever. So I'm going to show you how you can set up Factorio in here, and it's probably the easiest way, or one of the easiest ways, to get a Factorio server up and running. So if you don't have Pterodactyl, it's free. I've got a video in the description. I'll show you how to set it up on your server. But basically, once you've set up Pterodactyl, you'll be brought to a dashboard like this. So all we need to do is click on settings on the right hand side. And then first thing we need to do is make a nest. So basically there's these things in Pterodactyl called eggs, and eggs are basically server configurations, and a nest is like pretty much a folder that all the eggs go in. So the first thing we need to do is just like go create new, and then we're going to create one called custom games, then just click save. And then once we've done that, we click back on nests, and then we click on import egg. So I'm going to import the egg. I'll leave a link to the description. Basically, there's this dude called Parker, and he's got a pretty much just every egg for Pterodactyl in one handy place. So I'll give you the Factorio egg. It's literally, it'll just be in the description. And then basically we just got to go the associated nest, and we'll set that to custom games. It can go in any of those, but like, I just like to keep things organized. So let's click on import. So there we go, we've got the egg imported, and now we need to click on servers, because we're going to start this server now. Click create new, then we're going to go Factorio. Then the server owner, put in your name. We can leave the node allocations, everything just default. Let's set memory. We're going to set memory and disk space to 0. And then we come down to the nest configuration. We're going to select the custom games nest, and we're going to select the Factorio egg. And then scroll down. Basically, we can leave everything else here as default. The only thing we need is our Factorio.com token. So to get the token, we need to go to Factorio.com. So we need to log in. Now, if you've purchased through Steam, then you're going to click on sign in through Steam. So I'm going to sign in. And then once you've logged in, basically you just click on your profile page up the top right. So you click your username, and then your token will be there. So once you've got your token, just come back to Pterodactyl and just paste your server token in here. Don't worry, don't use this token because it will be invalid. You have to use your own token. You can set your server name, you can set your server username, whatever else you want to set up here. Then click create server. So the whole token thing is like where a lot of people get stuck with Factorio. It used to be a lot harder. Like you said, to go into your configuration files and set up like some weird JSON for with your Steam login and stuff, and it's pretty jank. But now it's like, it's pretty easy just by going straight to the website. So all we need to do now is just wait for this to finish, and then once it's finished, we'll just log into the server. Okay, so now that we can see the server's running in the top left hand corner, now we can just copy our IP address. So you can just click it and it'll copy it to the clipboard. And then let's jump into Factorio. Okay, so once you're inside of Factorio, then we can just click on multiplayer, and we can click connect to address. So once we connect to address, we can just put in our IP that we copied, click connect, and it will download the world. And then we're in. We're playing on our Factorio server. It's that simple. Use it, like, trust me, guys, using Pterodactyl, it's freaking awesome compared to doing everything on a command line or just some weird app. It's definitely worth the install on your server. So That's all for today, guys. If you got any questions or you get stuck, leave a comment below or come and join us on Discord. And if this video helped you, give me a like and subscribe. It will really help out. So thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.